Psycho, Texas Chainsaw Massacre, and The Silence of the Lambs, these iconic horror movies that hit the theaters throughout the century. These movies all horrified audiences, but many don't know the story that brought these movies to life. That story came from the quiet town of Plainfield, Wisconsin, and on November 16, 1957, the town would find a horrifying truth about one of their residents. That resident was Ed Gein, and would later be known as the Butcher of Plainfield. Ed Gein was born in 1906 in La Crosse, Wisconsin. He was born to an alcoholic father named George Philip, a freakishly religious mother named Augusta Wilhelm Gein, and an older brother named Henry George Gein. Ed's father owned a local grocery shop, while his mother, she was a stay-at-home mom. Augusta, a fervent Lutheran, preached to her boys the innate immortality of the world, the evil of drinking, and the belief that all women, although excluding herself, were prostitutes and instruments of the devil. One day, she insisted on leaving the La Crosse home and moved to Plainfield, Wisconsin, claiming their town had become a Sodom and a Gomorrah. Using the money from the local grocery store they ran, they were able to buy a farmhouse just outside of Plainfield. Isolating themselves most of the time, the family slowly started to spiral, and sooner or later, Ed developed a strange love-hate relationship with his mother. Henry, Ed's older brother, questions his brother's mental capability when Ed is alone with his mother. Most days, before the age of 14, Ed leaves his home to go to school. And besides his learning, Ed spends most of his time doing chores around the farm. By 1940, Ed Gein's father dies of a heart attack caused by his alcoholism, and things only got worse in the Gein family. On May 16, 1944, a bushfire burned close to the farm, and the Gein brothers went out to extinguish it. Reportedly, the brothers were separated, and Ed lost sight of his brother. After the fire was extinguished, Ed reported his brother missing to the police. Sooner or later, Ed led them directly to a body burned to the point where it was not identifiable. Rumors stirred in the community that the body was Henry Gein, and bruises were found on the head. But with the burden that was brought upon the Gein family, police ruled Henry's death as an accident, despite evidence showing that Ed was likely the killer. Months after burying Henry, Augusta suffered a stroke that left her partially paralyzed. Later, in 1945, she suffered another stroke that ultimately leads to her death. Since the devastating death of his mother, Gein's world disappeared, and this caused him to slowly spiral into insanity. Despite Gein living isolated outside of Plainfield, Gein managed to support himself by working several odd jobs. Gein worked diligently around the clock, but his creepy, unusual behavior became prominent over time. One day, a woman named Mary Hogan, a tavern owner outside of Pine Grove that Gein visited frequently, mysteriously disappeared. Questions were risen, but in the end, the case closed as there was no leads to Hogan's whereabouts. On November 16, 1957, Plainfield hardware store owner Bernice Warden disappeared. Warden's son told investigators that Ed Gein was in the store the evening before the disappearance, saying that Gein would return the following morning. A receipt for antifreeze was found at the hardware store. Police arrested Ed and headed to Gein's house, where they'll find a gruesome discovery which will be later known as the House of Horrors. While Gein was being interviewed at the police station, officers arrived at Gein's household, which will be later known as the House of Horrors. In a shed connected to the house, they'll find a gruesome discovery. They find the decapitated body of Bernice Warden, but it wasn't the only gut-wrenching thing they found. From the messy bedroom to the kitchen and living room, they found skulls used as bowls, a belt made out of human skin, and furniture upholstered by human skin. But what made it more horrifying was the officer finding the head of Mary Hogan in a paper bag. But oddly enough, out of all the rooms in the house being a mess, Augusta's room was the cleanest of them all, aside from the dust built up over time. While the officers were busy searching the house, Gein was being interviewed by a private investigator. He admitted that the skulls and human skin were from the graves of the Plainfield Cemetery. He instructs that after finding out the passing of a person, he would immediately rob their graves. It was estimated that he robbed at least 15 or more graves, and used the bones and skin as everyday household items. Ed even admitted to killing Mary Hogan and Bernice Warden, but not to the missing residents in Plainfield. But more importantly, he added that both Mary Hogan and Bernice Warden were a close lookalike to his late mother, Augusta. On November 21st, 1957, Gein was arrested for first-degree murder in Washtenaw County Court. He pleaded not guilty due to his insanity. After the doctors found Gein mentally incompetent and unfit for the trial, he was sent to the Central State Hospital for the Criminally Insane, a facility located in Wappan, Wisconsin. He was later transferred to the Mendota State Hospital in Madison, Wisconsin. He was labeled as a well-behaved patient throughout his time in the hospital. By 1968, Gein's doctor determined he was sane enough for the trial. The trial began on November 14, 1968, and was found guilty of first-degree murder of Bernice Worden by Judge Robert H. Goldmar. Due to the financial issues, Gein wasn't able to be tried for the murder of Mary Hogan. In the end, he had to spend the rest of his life in the Mendota State Hospital, despite the fact he was deemed mentally sane enough for the trial. On July 26, 1984, Gein died of a respiratory and heart failure due to cancer at the Mendota Mental Health Institute. His gravesite in Plainfield Cemetery was frequently vandalized over the years, and in late 2000, Gein's casket was stolen, but was later recovered outside of Seattle in June of 2001, and now is residing in the Museum of Washura County.